Good morning. Today we are going to review the simple harmonic motion topics covered on the AP Physics 1 exam.
Hey guys.
Hey, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
Flippin' Physics.
A typical example of an object in simple harmonic motion is a horizontal mass spring system on a frictionless surface. This is a mass attached to a spring. Currently, it is in the equilibrium or rest position, and if I take that mass and pull it to the right, we can call this position number one, and notice the force of the spring is to the left. And if we let go of the mass, it will slide to the left and go through the equilibrium position. Let's call this position number two. And at this point, the displacement from equilibrium position is equal to zero. Therefore, the force of the spring, which is equal to the spring constant times the displacement from equilibrium position. Therefore, at position number two, because the displacement from equilibrium position is equal to zero, the force of the spring is equal to zero. Notice this is different than our first drawing where the velocity of the block was equal to zero. Here, the velocity of the block is actually to the left and the block will continue to move to the left. Let's call this position number three. Notice here that the force of the spring is to the right. Notice that the force of the spring is always pointed toward the equilibrium position and increases proportionally with the displacement from equilibrium position. This force of the spring is called a restoring force. A restoring force is what causes simple harmonic motion. And simple harmonic motion is the idea that this object will go from position 1 to 2 to 3 to 2 to 1 to 2 to 3 to 2 to 1 to 2 to 3 to 2 and so on. And this will continue without friction forever. Also notice that the mass will never get farther from the equilibrium position than it does at positions 1 and 3. Therefore, we call this maximum displacement from equilibrium position the amplitude. According to Newton's second law, if the force of the spring is equal to zero at position number 2, then the net force is equal to zero, then the acceleration at position number 2 is equal to zero. We can also look at the accelerations at position 1 and 3. Because the displacement from equilibrium position is at its maximum value, the force of the spring is going to be at its maximum value. Therefore, the magnitude of the maximum force will be a maximum. Therefore, the magnitude of the accelerations at positions 1 and 3 will be a maximum. And the block changes directions at positions 1 and 3. Therefore, the velocity there will be zero. Which means the block will have a maximum magnitude velocity at position 2. We can also look at simple harmonic motion in terms of circular motion. An object moving in a circle can look like this. We can solve for the x position of the object moving in a circle using the cosine of theta. By definition, the cosine of theta equals the adjacent divided by the hypotenuse, and therefore it's equal to the x position divided by the radius. And we get that the x position is equal to the radius times the cosine of the angle. And we can use the equation for period in terms of frequency and angular velocity that's on your equation sheet. Multiply this equation by angular velocity and frequency, and we get the angular velocity equals 2 pi times the frequency. Now, this omega is actually called the angular frequency, but you can see it comes from the angular velocity. In fact, we can use the equation for angular velocity. Angular velocity equals angular displacement over change in time, or angular position final minus angular position initial, all divided by time final minus time initial. And if we set our initial conditions equal to zero, we get angular velocity equals angular position divided by time, or multiplying by time, that angular position equals the angular velocity, or angular frequency, times time. And combining all these equations gives us The x position of the particle equals the radius times the cosine of the quantity 2 pi times frequency times time. And if we set the radius of the circle equal to the amplitude in simple harmonic motion, we get the equation that is on your equation sheet for the x position of an object in simple harmonic motion. Okay, let's now look at this in terms of a graph. You can see the position graph follows exactly what we talked about before. The mass spring system oscillates back and forth between positions 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Yes, Billy?
The horizontal axis isn't labeled. What is on the horizontal axis?
It's a good question. This is a graph of cosine of theta. However, we showed that theta is equal to 2 pi times the frequency times time. And it is important to realize that we defined theta in terms of radians. Therefore, we need to use radians in our equation for position. And therefore, these are not 90, 180, 270, and 360 degrees. These are pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and 2 pi radians. Please be careful of that. Just to be absolutely clear, the mass starts out at position number 1, moves to position number 2, then 3, then 2, and then back to position number 1. At positions 1 and 3, the displacement from equilibrium position of the mass has its maximum magnitude, which is the amplitude. Therefore, the force caused by the spring has its maximum magnitude, and therefore the acceleration has its maximum magnitude. Also at positions 1 and 3, the mass changes directions, so its velocity is 0. At position number 2, the displacement from the equilibrium position is 0, therefore the force of the spring is 0, and therefore the acceleration of the mass is 0. Also at position number 2, the mass has its maximum magnitude velocity. We show that the position of the mass-spring system is described by the equation position equals amplitude times the cosine of 2 pi times the frequency times time. You can see the maximum magnitude displacements at positions 1 and 3, and at position number 2, the mass is at its equilibrium position. Now, let's look at a graph of velocity. Notice how this matches what we determined before. The velocity is 0 at the two most extreme positions, positions 1 and 3, and it has its maximum magnitude at the equilibrium position, or position number 2.
All right, and you can see if the mass is moving to the left or to the right based on whether the velocity is positive or negative.
Bo, that's correct. Now let's look at the graph of the acceleration of the mass. Again, it matches what we said before. The maximum magnitude acceleration is at the most extreme positions, positions 1 and 3, and the acceleration is 0 at the equilibrium position, position number 2. It is very important to notice that the acceleration during simple harmonic motion is not uniformly accelerated motion. So you cannot use the uniformly accelerated motion equations. It is also good to look at the mechanical energies as well. Here is the kinetic energy of the mass. Bobby, what do you notice about the kinetic energy of the mass?
The kinetic energy is never negative because the velocity is squared. And kinetic energy is 0 where the velocity is 0 at the two endpoints, 1 and 3, and a maximum where the velocity is a maximum at the equilibrium position, or position 2.
Very nice, Bobby. This is the elastic potential energy of the mass. Billy, what do you see?
Just like kinetic energy, the elastic potential energy is never negative because the displacement from equilibrium position is squared. At the equilibrium position, there is no elastic potential energy because the displacement from equilibrium position is 0. And when the mass is at the amplitude positions 1 and 3, the elastic potential energy is at its maximum.
Absolutely, Billy. Now, notice what happens when we add kinetic energy to the graph in red. And then we add the kinetic energy and the elastic potential energies together to get the total mechanical energy, which is now on the graph in green. Who can tell me what major physics concept the total mechanical energy on this graph illustrates?
Oh, I get it. The total mechanical energy is constant.
So mechanical energy is conserved?
Yes. There is no friction, and there is no force applied adding energy to the system via work, so this is conservation of mechanical energy.
That's right. Simple harmonic motion without friction is conservation of mechanical energy. Bobby, what is the period of a mass spring system?
The period of a mass spring system equals 2 pi times the square root of the mass of the object divided by the spring constant.
And Billy, what is the equation for the period of a pendulum in simple harmonic motion?
The period of a pendulum equals 2 pi times the square root of the length of the pendulum divided by the acceleration due to gravity. And the length of the pendulum is specifically the distance from the center of suspension at the top of the string to the center of mass of the pendulum.
And Bobby, what is the definition of the period?
The period is the time it takes for an object to go through one full cycle.
Then, Bo, let's say we have a pendulum and a mass spring system, and we take them both to the moon. What happens to their periods?
The period of the mass spring system will not change because the acceleration due to gravity is not in the equation. However, the period of a pendulum will increase because the period of a pendulum is inversely related to the square root of the acceleration due to gravity, which is less on the moon.
And Bobby, if instead of taking them to the moon, we increase their masses, what happens to their periods?
The period of the pendulum will stay the same because it is independent of mass. And the period of the mass spring system will increase because it is directly proportional to the square root of the mass of the mass spring system.
And notice that amplitude is not in either one of these two equations. Therefore, the period of a pendulum and a mass spring system are independent of their amplitudes. We have reached the end of my review of simple harmonic motion for AP Physics 1. My next review lesson is about waves. You are more than welcome to enjoy that video. You can also go to my website, flippingphysics.com, where you will find all of my review lessons for AP Physics 1 organized with lecture notes. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.